There's a little pile of ashes where my old life used to be. Credit cards and memories all dumped into the sea. Well, this ain't no time for bull as I fly into the sun. Well, you can't trust anybody if you can't trust number one. Well, the man tells me my future is not so far away. To get ready for tomorrow, I gotta waste my whole day. My inner light knows better, but it's what I wanna hear. Just like a diamond bullet, but it's crystal, crystal clear, oh yeah!
In which Jun Kazama became the first ever Vixens champion. Our second one was at Pandemonium, where Emma Frost emerged victorious. And now, Can her partner in crime, Poison Ivy, or any other five Vixens in this match, can they achieve success just as Kazama and Frost did? Now to just to go over the rules, as here comes competitor number two. Out of the mean streets of New York City, it's Black Cat. To those that are fairly new to FvH, here's how the six-pack challenge goes. All six ladies will be at the ring in one time. Elimination occurs only by pinfall or submission. The last Vixen standing will get, at any time she desires, a one-on-one shot at the Vixen's title. Now, just to clarify, this is not like Money in the Bank where you can just cash it in willy-nilly. You have to talk to, have to sign the contract with the champion in order to get that match. Here comes competitor number three. Believe it or not, still undefeated. Omarosa, reality TV's bad girl, has yet to be pinned or made to submit here in FvH so far. You can actually say she has a 1-in-6 chance of keeping that streak alive. But wouldn't it be a feather in her cap if step 1 out of 6 came true?
But now I'm back.
And she wins this whole event.
And you're not getting done.
As I said before, the winner of this match,
I'm not a vendor.
We'll have the privilege of choosing, whenever they so choose, their shot at the Vixens champion, whoever that may be. Don't forget, we got the Vixens championship on the line tonight as Faye Valentine looks to wrest the gold away from Emma Frost. As here comes the next competitor, possibly the Cinderella story in this match. The spunky member of the X-Men, Jubilee, who earned her spot on the season finale of Heatwave, beating El Driver. And she followed that up with getting a pinfall victory in a tag match on the last edition of Showtime. So she's coming in with a wave of momentum right now. Now, competitor number five, representing the Matrix, the one and only Trinity. Trinity has had an up and down season here in FvH. She would like nothing more, as all the other females here in this match, to be the last Vixen standing and earn a shot at the Vixen's title. And rounding out the six Vixen in this six-pack challenge, representing the Voltron Force, is Princess Allura. No doubt she had to get herself and her boys ready, because Voltron Force, Lance and Keith, will defend the tag titles against Dwayne Wade and Chris Bosh. But can the Princess of FvH secure her spot? One way to find out, here we go! Now again, all six ladies are in the ring. No disqualifications, no countouts. It's just either pinfall or submission. You get either one of them, you are gone. And look, Jubilee already! Roll up on Laura, you'll get the two count. Vertical suplex by Trinity. Back body drop by Black Cat. Already, you already know, if you've seen the last two six-pack challenges, It's going to get ugly. It's going to get wild. And for me, commentating this is gonna get sometimes confusing. So bear with me. Again, what a way to start off Moment of Truth here in Cleveland. Now Can Trinity trading blows. Now look at this. Can on Allura again. Every vixen for herself. Oh wait, look at this. Nice head scissors by Ken on Ivy. Ivy, oh, running kick. Right across the chest of Poison Ivy and a helo. Nicely done. Oh, nice drop kick by Trinity. About to send Jubilee down, but Omarosa stopped there. And wait a minute. Ivy pushing the referee out of the way. Lane Mills already taking a spill. Neck breaker by Trinity on Omarosa. And oh, drop kick right to the back of the head of Allura. Good thing she has that helmet on. Jubilee gets spiked with a DDT by Trinity. Now swinging neck breaker by Cat. Again, no elimination so far. Again, oh wait a minute. STF. STF by Trinity. A roll up by Allura and Cat kicks out in two. Again, pinfall or submission is the only way you get eliminated. Feliner. Ken hits the feline on Jubilee, but Ken did decide to go for the cover instead. Brought her back up to her feet. That may come back and haunt her. Nice flying forearm there by Princess. Back body drop counter by Ken. Now Cat focusing on Poison Ivy. Irish whip, clothesline duck. Oh, look at the move by Cat! What a move by Black Cat on Poison Ivy! Now follows that up with an innovative leg drop. And there it is! Nine lives moonsault!
One,
hook on the leg!
Three.
Poison Ivy is eliminated! She tried to go for a standing moonsault on Omarosa. It didn't pay off. And now Omarosa just got caught, but just not even a one count. Poison Ivy has been eliminated by Ken. And wait a minute. Oh, surprise by Allura. Small package. And oh, man, that was close. We almost said bye-bye to Trinity, thanks to Allura. And now, five females remain. One of these five will have the privilege of naming their title shot, so to speak. Hip toss counter by Omarosa, nicely done. Now Trinity and Jubilee working each other. Swinging neck breaker by Trinity. Now Jubilee focuses her attention on Black Cat. Now Allura has her. With swinging neck breaker of her own. And knee right across the forehead. Oh, look at that combination by Omarosa! Good grief, she spiked her! Hook on the leg! One,
two, three.
Bye-bye, Trinity! But look at down the lower right! Should say lower left! Cat has a cover on Jubilee!
Three.
And she's eliminated!